Hi, this is William from Great Affordable Watches, and in this video I'm gonna put together a three-piece watch collection at around $1,000. And I have done a very similar video to this, but with a three-piece watch collection around $500. So if you're interested in that price range as well, go check out that video. I can leave a link to it down in the description. But now let's go through a three-piece watch collection around $1,000 that offers great value and some excellent watches. And we can start with the Hamilton Khaki Field Mechanical. And this is basically the manual or mechanical version of the very popular and famous Khaki Field Automatic. And as we can see, it's pretty similar to the automatic version. The dial is a bit different. I think this one is a bit more understated, a bit more clean, but both watches are great. The mechanical or manual version is a bit thinner than the automatic version thanks to the manual wound movement. Me personally, I prefer the mechanical version over the automatic because of the very simple, very clean design, and it shares a lot of similarities with the old World War field watches, which I really like. And this watch is also a bit cheaper than the automatic version at around $270 on Jaume Shop. And if you plan on spending a bit more money, I can also recommend the automatic version, but if you like the look of this one and you want to keep the price down, I think this is an excellent choice. Okay, let's move on to a dive watch, because I think a watch collection should have at least one dive watch or something very sporty with a high water resistance that you can use every day and don't have to worry about it. And I thought a lot about a really nice diving watch, and there are a lot of great microbrand diving watches, but as with the three-piece watch collection under $500, I choose the Seiko SKX 013. Or if you prefer the bigger version, SKX 009 or 007. Basically the same watch, the 013 is a bit smaller. I prefer the smaller version, as some of you guys know. But no matter which one you get, they are excellent watches. I thought a lot about this position and I wanted to pick something else, something other than the SKX. But I couldn't really find anything that got that iconic look, that history, the quality, the finishing and all that. I think the SKX is just an amazing watch, especially at the price point of around $200, a bit less if you opt for the rubber strap. And I think it's really hard to beat that watch at that price point. And instead, I went for a bit more expensive dress watch, as we're gonna get into a bit later. And I must say, can get a microbrand watch, you can get a Tissell for example at around $200 as well, but the SKX is so iconic and I personally really love it, so I think you can't really go wrong with it. But it's a bit boring perhaps to see a SKX in every watch collection and in every video here on YouTube, but it's a reason it's so popular, and that's because of the quality and the heritage. And because I opted for the SKX, I could go for a more expensive dress piece, and I have two options. One that exceeds the budget a bit, but I think it's worth it, and one that's within the budget. So this is completely up to you if you wanna go for something a bit more expensive or get something a bit cheaper that can stay under $1,000. And we can start with the more expensive piece, and that's the Milo Baroncelli Heritage 3. And some of you guys may have seen my review of this watch, and I've also talked about it in some of my other videos. And I absolutely love this watch. The quality and the specs for the price at around $600, give or take, depending on which dial color you get. I had the white version, but I think the black version looks as good, if not better looking, than the white version. And this watch is pretty special. It got a highly decorated ETA 2892 top grade with blued screws, diamond bridges, perlage and all that, basically fully decorated, as decorated a standard or mass-produced ETA can get. You can get some higher decoration with, for example, Tudor and etc., Longines and IWC watches, but when it comes to standard ETA, this is the most decoration you can get from what I have seen, and it's only 6.95 millimeters thick, so it's a extremely thin watch. I can leave a link to my review down in the description as well. I think it's just an amazing watch for the money. I think the only gripe I got with it is the case. I think it wears a bit large at 39 millimeters, but the case shape and all that makes it a bit large in my personal opinion. But other than that, I think this is one of the best dress watches, if not the best dress watch you can get under $1,000. But as I said, if you want something a bit cheaper, you can opt for the Hamilton Intramatic, and especially the 38 millimeter version. I think it wears amazing. I would avoid the 42 millimeter version, both because it's pretty hard to sell if you intend to sell it someday, and because it wears extremely large thanks to the all dial case basically. And the Hamilton Intermatic is almost the same value as the Mido. It also got a ETA 2892, a Le Bar grade, not a top grade, and the decoration is a bit more industrial looking, which I really like. And yeah, I must say the size a bit better on this one. It wears a bit more comfortable at 38 millimeters. It wears perhaps a bit bigger than that thanks to the old dial case, but this watch is just amazing, and I think the case and the case finishing is a bit better on the Hamilton versus the Mido, so that's a big plus. But then again, it's a bit thicker and a bit worse of a movement, if you can call it worse. So it's a bit of a trade-off between the two watches. If you want a highly decorated movement, a extremely thin watch under $1,000, and you want to spend a bit more money, I would go for the Mido. But if you want something perhaps a bit more industrial looking and with a movement that is not as good looking as the Mido, but you prefer the size and the case, which I think, as I said, is a bit better on the Hamilton, I would go for the Hamilton Intramatic. And especially in the black color, I think it's absolutely gorgeous. In my watch collection video, I talk briefly about the Hamilton Intramatic, and you can see some more angles and some more photos of it. So if you want to see more of the Hamilton, you can go check out the watch collection video in 2018. Okay, that's all three watches. And as always, let me know what you think of this video down in the comment section. And if you have any other alternative, especially when it comes to diving watches, great diving watches under $500, leave them in the comment section down below. I would love to hear what's your favorite diving watch in that price range is. So yeah, just leave your comment down in the comment section. And I hope you liked this video. And if you did, please leave a like. And if you aren't already subscribing to my channel, please do that as well for more watch-related content. And I hope I see you in the next one.